नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर एस लाल, प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एंड कंप्यूटिंग, द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ अंडर द फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी ऑफ ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. स्टूडेंट्स, एज पर योर सेशन today I will discuss on the next method of integration. So please let us write the topic, the method we are going to discuss today. This is method of, please write, method of substitution, S U B S S I T U T I U N, method of substitution. You know the term substitute. Substitute as bicycle is the substitute of your motorcycle. Your old car is the substitute of your BMW. But your hands are not substitutes of your eyes. So method of substitution means what? The very basic meaning of this ideology here is that suppose you are given a function that is not easily integrable, then how to make this function integrable? For that very purpose, if you put some suitable substitute, then your function becomes easily integrable. So you should learn this method smartly, because throughout your study this will play vital role. So method of substitution is not only for algebraic function or for trigonometrical function. You can apply this method in either of the functions where you need to apply to get the easy path, easy way to find the integration of a given function. Just I'm giving you a problem and request you that please write. So write the problem. Question is this. Write the question. Evaluate, evaluate, then write sine of integration sine root x divided by root x into dx. You have written evaluate, then you have written sine of integration sine root x divided by root x into dx. So how to get solution of this problem by the method of substitution? Write solution. Write let capital I is equal to sine of integration sine root x by root x into dx. Take it as equation one. Now let root under x is equal to z. We are going to search a suitable substitute. So we are putting root under x, that is giving you some confusion. Due to root x, you are fearing here that how to find the integration of the given problem. So to get rid of that problem, you have to write, you have to suppose root under x is equal to z. Now differentiate both sides. Please write, differentiating both sides. Differentiating both sides with respect to x. Then we have d by dx root x is equal to dz by dx. D by dx of root x is equal to dz by dx. And you know from your previous class that differentiation of root x is what? It is equal to 1 upon 2 into root x. And this will be dz by dx. Now, just by cross multiplication process, this will be dx by root x in LHS is equal to in RHS 2 into dz. This is equation 2. Now see equation 1 and equation 2. In equation 1, that is your question, and here is dx upon root x. Please see, dx upon root x is there. So for dx upon root x, what you can write? You can write 2 into dz. So you write here, now, please write, now putting the value of equation 2, putting the value of equation 2 in equation 1, we get I is equal to limit of integration sine z, because for root x you have to write z, and for dx upon root x is equal to 2 into dz. So you have written here integrate sine of integration sine z into 2 into dz. 2 will be out from the integration process, that as this is constant. So this is what? This is sine z into dz. And sine z, integration of sine z is what? It will be minus cos z. 2 minus cos z plus k. This is equal to minus 2 cos. And z means what? As you have substituted, z means you can't write your answer in the form of z because your question is in the form of x. So your answer should be in the form of x. So what you have found in the last step, you have found minus 2 cos z plus k. So for z you can write root x plus k. This is our integration. So student, you have seen, you are just observing here that how easy is your method of substitution. Once you take a suitable substitute, your problem of integration becomes very easy. The question what I have just solved has been question of engineering entrance examination, as well as this question has been in different university examination also since 1986 to till today. I recall this question because when I was a student, this was also a question for me. So I recall this question, and you should also remember this question, because anybody can ask you that what is the integration of sine root x divided by root x into dx. So the method what I have written here, but the process what I have adopted here, you have to adopt the same, and you know that just by doing exercise, it is possible for you to reproduce your numerical answer, numerical problems. So don't read this answer as a novel. Don't listen this as a story. Whenever you are planning to study, you must have pen and papers in your hand always. This is my keen advice to all the students. As a teacher, or as my experience said, as a student also. So a student, you know this digital session. This session is powered by digital version 2.0 of Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. In case of any query or doubt, you should write your comment in the inbox. I shall try to resolve your query from there. Thank you for enjoying this lecture. Thanks.